At the tail end of the Cold War, the Soviet Union produced a number of unique aircraft carriers, known as the Kiev class. The carriers were the Soviet initial foray into the world of fixed-wing naval aviation, and the only Soviet carriers to become fully operational. The story of the Kiev carriers is also the story of a land power forging a path to become a naval power, seeking to realize a fleet that could challenge the mighty US Navy. The Kiev-class aircraft carriers had their origin in the tenure of Admiral Sergei Gorshkov, appointed by Nikita Khrushchev to the position of Commander-in-Chief of the Soviet Navy in 1956. Gorshkov served in that position for a remarkable 29 years. He oversaw the expansion of the Soviet Navy from a strategically insignificant force in the years after World War II to a well-balanced one that could project power into the Third World. A problem that became obvious during the Cuban Missile Crisis, when the Soviet Navy had no long-range striking forces it could send to meet the US naval blockade of Cuba. While Gorshkov devoted a huge amount of the Soviet Navy's construction budget into submarines, particularly ballistic missile submarines, he wanted a balanced force capable of projecting power overseas. Faced with the imminent deployment of longer-range submarine-launched Trident C-3 missiles, the Soviet Navy would have to operate even farther from the Eurasian continent in order to counter them. This would pitch the Soviet Navy directly against the carrier task forces of the US Navy. At the same time, more countries were falling into the Soviet orbit, providing the USSR with port facilities. Cuba in the Western Hemisphere, Vietnam in Asia, Angola in Africa, Syria, Egypt, Yemen, and Libya in the Middle East, and Ethiopia and Somalia in the Horn of Africa, all provided encouragement for the Soviet Navy to visit and demonstrate fraternal socialism. If the Soviet Union wanted to keep and even expand a network of overseas allies, it would need a naval force complete with capital ships capable of visiting such allies and engaging in visible shows of support. In 1975, Kiev appeared, followed by her sister ship Minsk, Novorossiysk, and Baku. All four were built at the Nikolaev South Shipyard in Ukraine, the Soviet Union's only constructor of large surface warships. Like the Moskva class before them, the vessels were a mixed ship types, with the front half resembling a guided missile cruiser and the remainder of the ship resembling an aircraft carrier. At 899 feet, the ships were approximately 85% as long as the US Navy's new Nimitz class carriers. The forward half of the ship had a considerable amount of firepower, with 8 SSN-12 sandbox anti-ship missiles. Each SSN-12 known 4K80 in the Soviet Union carried a 2,000-pound high-explosive warhead or a 350-kiloton nuclear warhead. The sandbox had a range of 341 miles, with targeting data provided by shore-based Tu-95 maritime patrol aircraft or helicopters from the Kiev Air Wing. The nuclear warhead options would have been particularly effective against US carrier battle groups, with only a single missile needing to penetrate US defenses to ensure the carrier's destruction. A capital ship designed to go head-to-head with an American carrier needed formidable air defenses, and the Kiev class did not disappoint. The first three ships featured a pair of twin-rail SAN-3 NATO reporting name Goblet surface-to-air missile launchers with 72 missiles below deck, while the fourth ship Baku received a weapons upgrade with 192 9K330 TOR anti-air missiles replacing the SAN-3S. The ships also carried 40 9K-33 OSA missiles, the sea-based version of the land-based short-range SA-8 Gekko missile. Finally, for close-in defense against incoming missiles, each Kiev had 8 AK-630 30mm radar-directed Gatling guns. Other standard armament included two sets of 76mm dual-purpose guns, one facing forward and one facing rear, two RBU-6000 anti-submarine multiple rockets launchers, and 10 anti-submarine torpedoes. The breakup of the Soviet Union left the ship in the hands of the Russian Federation, which could not afford to maintain them. Worse, the Nikolaev South Shipyard and spare parts were now in a separate country, Ukraine. All of the Kiev class were retired and a fifth unnamed ship was never built. Kiev was sold to China, where it became a hotel, while Minsk will reportedly be part of a theme park. Novorossiysk was broken up at Pohang, South Korea in the 1990s. Of all four mighty ships, only one Baku remains, the most advanced ship in the best condition of all four. Baku was retained, renamed Admiral Gorshkov, and then sold to the Indian government to be converted into a full aircraft carrier, converted by Russia's Sevma shipyards in the 2000s and 2010. Today it is known as the aircraft carrier Vikramaditya and is the flagship of the Indian fleet. The Kiev-class carriers were an ambitious attempt to give Russia a powerful ship capable of taking on American aircraft carriers while at the same time hunting down submarines that posed a threat to the Soviet homeland. Because responsibilities were split between two vastly different, their ability to do either was severely curtailed. Ships that are half one type of ship and half another, like Japan's World War II Ice-class aircraft carrier battleships, are usually a failure at being both. The Kiev class was no exceptions.